Former FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe is under fire from conservative media for recent comments he made comparing Trump supporters to terrorists during a virtual panel called Protecting American Democracy: Lessons from the Capitol Riot.
From my perspective of spending a lot of time focused on the radicalization of international terrorists and Islamic extremists and extremists of all stripes, what we are seeing and what Professor Pape's research makes clear is that this group shares many of the same characteristics of those groups that we've seen radicalized along entirely different ideological lines.
Ryan, he just came out and said it. I mean, he just like explicitly made the like Intercept Federalist synergy explicit in that he's directly connecting his research and his experience policing Islamic terrorists to domestic like right-wing terrorists. And what he's saying is that we need to heighten our surveillance of domestic right-wing groups in the same way we heightened our surveillance of Islamic groups after 9/11. Is that not exactly what he's saying here?
That does seem to be what he's saying quite precisely. And he could even be right about the political analysis. Like there are, of course, there are similarities between left-wing movements, between right-wing movements, between between ideological movements of all stripes. That's why they're under the rubric of ideological movements. The question then becomes, well, what is the government's responsibility? How is the government supposed to handle this? And for a decade and a half, actually, for more than that, going back to the 60s, 70s, the left has been saying this is the government has no right to suppress, crack down on, to criminalize these types of political movements. And now it is very, and there's some on the right who on principle agreed with that, but it was a minority position. Now it is nice that people like the entire conservative movement slamming McCabe are finally understand what was wrong about the way that they were approaching previous movements.
100%. And I think there is, like, if I were someone on the left, I'd be like, you're completely late to the party.
Yeah, welcome.
And it's true.
It took your guys getting caught up in FISA to understand that FISA was the problem that it is. I'm not talking about you, but like in general, like it was interesting seeing all the Republicans freaking about the FISA court and all the abuses. It's like, yeah, that's what the FISA court is built to do, is to abuse people.
Oh yeah, and I mean, I've seen so many people on the right citing Intercept reporting, not just from the last year, but from years back, like years
like, oh,
back
wait,
on this. Yeah, exactly. And I think, you know, there have always been libertarians, like even popular libertarians, Ron and Rand Paul, people with a lot of clout on the right who have been talking about this. But the mainstreaming of it is so important because it's such an incredible abuse, and it's an abuse that they're trying to make worse at the moment. They're actually actively, like for McCabe to say this, basically our reporter in Chicago saw this panel title, Protecting American Democracy, Lessons from the Capitol Riot, and saw that it was featuring McCabe and is like, I mean, come on, because this is the exact criticism that people have been making, and they literally just do not care. They're completely shameless to the point where everyone's saying you're doing the same thing you did after 9/11, and now you're applying it to like basically conservatives. You're inflating these definitions of what is a domestic extremist, what a terrorist is, to include normal people. And he's just like outright saying, I learned all of my lessons from the abuses of civil liberties that we committed after 9/11, and now we're going to apply them in the same abusive way.
Which was the warning that the left was making. It was like, look, okay, let's say you don't like Muslims,
right?
And you can't be motivated to care about the rights of Muslim people here in the United States or around the world. One way to try to get you to care about this is to say it might go beyond that, because this is not the type of mission that doesn't creep. That's what it does. And Ted Cruz was so close to getting it in his Tucker Carlson capitulation the other day, where Tucker's hammering him for calling the people who assaulted police officers on January 6th terrorists. And Ted Cruz's response was, look, Tucker, for the last year, I've been saying that Black Lives Matter protesters and Antifa protesters, anybody who attacks a police officer is a terrorist. That's what I've been saying, so I applied it consistently. And then he says, but I was wrong to do it in this case. And you could almost see a mind capable of getting there and then working backwards and saying, oh, wait, so maybe I shouldn't have been doing that to begin with, mm-hmm. if it's wrong in this case. He didn't go there. Maybe eventually he can get there. But it does expose that, you know, throwing around these labels of terrorist just because they're your political enemies is going to come back and catch you, even if you're the one doing it. Like, it came out of his mouth.
Right. And I'm curious to see, actually, if they do get there, especially in the context of, like, defund the police and back the blue, which makes it really interesting, a really interesting climate to have the conversation about policing and those sorts of abuses. But it is so critically important, I think, in this conversation about what happened on January 6th, the federal government's role in what happened on January 6th, potential role in what happened. This conversation, nobody wants to have it in the mainstream. It's absolutely being shut down. And in that shadow, McCabe and folks in the that are actually still currently in the surveillance apparatus, they're taking that and they're running with it.
And the forgotten history of this is that in 2001, right after the September 11th attacks, what was left of the left at that moment, which was, you know, in the thousands of people at that point, said this was. We should not call this a terror attack. Mm-hmm. Like the left was even saying September 11, 2001 is not a terror attack. It was a crime. It was an international crime. It was carried out by these, specifically by these 19 people, and it was orchestrated by this guy, Osama bin Laden. We need to indict him. We need to find him, extradite him, try him, and imprison him. Like that was the left's answer on 9/11, because they said if you assert that this is an act of terror, you're giving it more power than it deserves, and you're also then going to justify an overreaction to it. It's going to lead to endless wars. Now, that turned out to be correct, but to hold that position at that time drove you out of respectable conversation.
Yeah, my disagreement would be that two things can be true, that it can be an act of terrorism, and then you don't have to use that definition of terrorism to inflate and like lump in right. people who are not doing anything wrong. And again, on January 6th, I was reporting from the Capitol. There were people who were way back on Constitution Avenue, and there are people that have, you know, gotten calls from the FBI and have gotten visits from the FBI and have heard from them, who probably weren't involved in any wrongdoing, but have been surveilled nevertheless. Yeah. Well, tomorrow on Rising, I will be back. Journalist Jed Legum joins us to discuss how Red Lobster staff are reportedly being forced to work while sick due to lack of paid sick leave.
And Washington Post reporter Pamela Constable will help us break down the dire situation for many in Afghanistan facing a harsh winter and food shortages thanks to United States spite.
Well, be sure to like, share, and subscribe so you never miss a video. And just so the FBI can kind of keep tabs on where you are ideologically, it just makes it easier for them. Make sure to make their job a little bit easier.
Yeah, they'll appreciate that.
Have a great day.